Leo's voguing out here.
But anyway, we had the Lemyric Lexicon, and this is just an ongoing project, the Lemyric Lexicon, and so that you can talk like we do. You can talk like a lemur, at least like a babbling idiot, and so there's all kinds of terms in here, specialized language that we often use in the show.
Or at least aspire to.
Sure, so there's wonderful words like dung sack, meaning a disheveled, unkempt person, implies questionable hygiene. Tell that dung sack to use some deodorant. All right, we've got little, well, no, let's not. Let's see. nipply describes weather cold enough to harden your nipples. It's kind of nipply out there tonight, isn't it?
What about sturkification?
Well, then we have to explain the entire concept of Senor Sturkey. So tell them, Miss Elizabeth, about Senor Sturkey.
Senor Sturkey was born to a German woman and a Mexican father. He has a brother named Adolf Sturkey. Adolf Sturkey is the opposite of Senor Sturkey.
But he's his evil twin.
It's his evil twin, but he's the opposite because Senor Sturkey is good and everyone should love Senor Sturkey because he is awesome.
He is
a large, friendly Mexican, and he owns a chain of restaurants known as Senor Sturkey's Chunky Chicken.
In which he serves Senor Sturkey's turkey jerky.
Yes, and Senor Sturkey's Chunky Chicken has three types of chicken. There's the Chunky Chicken, the Chunkier Chicken, and the Chunkiest Chicken, which is the chunkiest of all. And there is even, in the works, perhaps Super Chunky Chicken. Can you imagine? But anyway...
Something even super and chunkier than the chicken were originally was.
And he's a dingus salesman.
Yeah, he was a dingus salesman, and then he had Senor Sturkey Snow Cone Shacks, and that didn't go too good. So he did that after the door-to-door dingus salesman. Mm-hmm. And then he opened his restaurant. The first restaurant opened in Cervix, Nebraska.
That's right.
And you see, most people... when they think of Nebraska, think of towns like, you know, Seattle or Denver. But it's kind of like when you think of New York, you know, you think the capital is New York City. No, it's Albany. Because, see, really, the capital of Nebraska is Cervix.
All right.
It's not Detroit or you know,
which
Seattle or Germany. It's Cervix. And so he set up in Cervix, and then he became enormously successful.
All right, which brings us to the term sturkification, or sturkified. To be sturkified is to have reached the absolute zenith of cool. It's a milestone on one's way toward achieving total sturkification. It means having reached about one-tenth of the cool of Senor Sturkey himself.
If you saw this man, you would just see that aura of coolness coming off him.
That's right.
We are the cast and crew and whatever Senor of the Abbey of the Lemur, and we're stirking tonight. We're stirking big time.
Stirking to beat the band.
Chicken. Senor Sturkey's Chunky Chicken.
Hey.
Marsupial.
All right. The Walk of Shame. Crawling home after a night of brutal partying, staggering homeward looking like complete hell while praying you won't be spotted by anyone you actually know. Yodeling across the porcelain fjord, puking. Duck with mauve lipstick, recipient of bad plastic surgery. Golden foaming sandwich, beer when consumed for lunch. Hurlometer, the measure of how much something will make you puke.
This is kind of relevant to the moment here.
The glass tit, that's television. And thanks to Harlan Ellison for that wonderful phrase. Legendary. Oh, yes.
Is that the guy that started KFC?
Yeah, Harlan Ellison, the
Colonel.
Sanders.
Yeah.
Okay, kirking, making a grandiloquent yet utterly vapid speech, often accompanied by exaggerated hand gestures, also refers to over-the-top hammy acting from Star Trek's Captain Kirk.
William Turdboy Shatner.
He can lay any alien woman.
Or man.
Indeed.
He's stirking.
Kelping, recovering from an alcohol binge, mentally floating about like kelp in the sea.
How is that used? How would you use that in a sentence?
Kelping, you would say, and it's in here as a sentence, so turn off that friggin' light, man. I'm kelping here. Mm. All right.
Guess I'll see you all on the ice.
Being kelpable.
Yes. Officer Krupke, any small-time petty law enforcement official from West Side Story. Can I say penis del pisto on the air? No, never mind.
No.
All right. Well, anyway.
He said penis.
I just did. Bohica, it's an acronym. Bend over, here it comes again.
Oh, right.
Hey, the janitor's coming with more stuff.
All right.